the Real People Multi-Game Solitaire Mega Tournament, it may just be that Cowboy is in trouble. We are at the Start Empire phase of the turn, just starting things off, and boom, there are the Ming. Now, who is controlling those Ming? It's Flush. Flush has the Ming. The Ming are a mighty empire, which are going to compete with the Han for China. I mean, they both want China. No, I guess the Ming, they just want Asia. But they're right there, right outside of the Han's empire. So now he's surrounded by Cowboys. Han are surrounded by Flush on three sides. He has the Japanese coming down there. He has... what are these guys? The Siamese down here, and then he has the Ming right outside his doorstep, and they have a strong stack here. Couple knights, the rest are all these swordsmen and also catapults, but they're stronger than the Hans. It's going to be tough for Cowboy. Luckily for Cowboy, he doesn't score a ton off the Han. Unluckily for Cowboy is if he loses China, that's going to be a big opportunity for Flush to score a lot more points. I forget when it was. Whenever it was that Little Red was eliminated, I talked, I think, a little bit about some of the sacrifices Flush had to make in order to make that happen. One of them that I might not have mentioned was Democracy. He took on Democracy, which makes it so that he loses a point if he attacks someone else. So the Japanese are kind of constrained right now. He would really like to take these spaces, but he can't as long as Cowboy's there. So things have gotten interesting. We have another new empire. It's the Spanish, owned by Giraffe. She's plopping them right down here in Castile, nestled in the crook of her Romans there. So they're really just kind of free to just expand and do what they want. Her mission, send the Spanish down into Africa. They score by having areas outside of Europe, and they also score by being the largest Christian empire. That can make, since the Romans are Christian, that could make them competitors in some sense. But, you know, they need some time to spread. So presumably she can shield them with the Romans so that they can go down in Africa, give some competition to Runt, and also end up scoring for Giraffe. She bought a lot of kind of weaker units with her money, so she could just get a lot and just send them out and just kind of flood down. We have finished our trade in progress phase. It was kind of similar to last turns, to tell you the truth. The Harappans, they traded again. I think they traded last time. It's been a couple days since I've played. They traded with the Han. I don't remember who they traded with last time, if they did trade last time. Makes a lot of sense. I mean, the Han are kind of alone among this field of Flush. She doesn't want to trade with the Phoenicians over here, so she also doesn't really want to trade with the Finns. They're both competitors, so the Han it is. That put the Harappans way up here. That gives them a nice handy lead. If the competition continues, though, between the Harappans and the Phoenicians, I could see us getting through this game rather more quickly because the Harappans score on progress, so she really wants to be ahead if she wants to hold on to them to make them worthwhile. What else happened? We saw another trade between the Plains Americans and the Aztecs there. They came out on top, so they're cruising along. They're in the elephant zone. Really, what Cowboy's looking for is to get them here, which if he gets another advantageous trade, he'll be able to do next time they trade. That's going to let him have stronger units. Remember, the Plains Americans and the Aztecs, anyone who starts off in the New World, basically, doesn't get the benefit of horses or boats. And so they're stuck with just the infantry and the missile units, which are the very earliest ones until you get up here. So he's really looking for that trade. What was the final trade we saw? Oh yeah, the Russians. We're seeing the Russians traded with the Finns again. An interesting move on their part. They're surrounded by the Finns, but they just keep helping them advance. And I think I forgot to actually advance them. The Finns lost out on the trade, so the Russians get to move up too. There we go. That was trade in progress. Melky's British have landed in Canada and in Brazil, there in South America. Not only did they do that, but they also killed a boat of Giraffe's Romans in the Bay of Biscay. Cowboy's striking back. He sent his gentleman here into Manchuria, as well as did some shifting to kind of try and defend his territory a little better. Defender definitely has an advantage in this game, which makes sense. I mean, they have one advantage. They have a territory advantage. I guess the attacker has the advantage of getting to decide what things look like when they attack. Handily beat the forces there. They weren't wasn't a very strong force. But just so you know, Cowboy's not waiting around. He's taking it to him. All right, that was a fairly quick turn. I think they're getting faster. It would stand to reason. We have fewer players. I'm more comfortable with the game. So let's take a look at our score track. Flush got 9 that turn. He did really, really rather good, and that flipped flipped everyone's counters over so Runt could score again. Runt's Egyptians are now tied by the English. The English actually are scoring as much as them in terms of points. They're getting 6. They get 3 for this out of Europe. So how that out of Europe works is they scored for having the most lands out of Europe among empires that have their capitals in Europe. So that's right now it's Rome, the Finns, I guess the Russians, and the Spanish, as well as the British. And since they're in the New World now, they have the most outside of Europe. So they scored on that. They scored on having the most boats, and they scored on having their homeland. His other two empires not doing so well. Also not doing so well, the Phoenicians, in terms of points, they only are scored 1 that turn. They no longer have the lead in terms of progress. And in fact, Cowboy, I think, was the lowest scorer that round. He had 5. He's going to have to change something. His Plains Americans are now getting infringed upon by 2 separate empires, both the British, the English, are going to, you know, they have a, they have an incentive to spread out in the New World because that, you know, that can help them keep that big 3 points, you know, and he's going to be competing with Spain, I think, primarily for that because Spain is going to spread into Africa, right? But he also has to compete with Runt's Aztecs there, and they have 4 spaces. He has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's a very small difference, so he could be losing his cash cow pretty soon. He also is in trouble here, you know, as we've already talked about. So interesting situation developing here. I'm liking this. I like this area. That's fun. These guys are really dull to me. The assassins haven't been able to do anything because they don't have any wreath cards, so that's kind of not fun. They got another guy. I think, you know, they just really haven't been a big focus for Milky. So yeah, that's where things are at. Scoring's happening. The Egyptians are really boring too. But lots of fun areas. I'm liking this, liking this, liking this, not so much liking this. We'll see what happens next time on the Real People Multi-Game Solitaire Mega Tournament.